Cool. So, hello. Welcome back again. Just got my thumbnail here open. Oh no, is it double me? Hang on. So, how's it going? Welcome to the fifth Danny Arcadia stream this week, I think. And yeah, today we're gonna be doing some animation. I already did a little bit, and I can kind of show you some of that, what I've been doing. It's pretty in Unity. I got the enemy there now, and I added a function so that he can roar, and he roars yeah. The roar is not final at all because I just did it really quickly. Ow! Fuck! Is that really loud? Oh, jeez. Ow. Let me do it again. I shouldn't have that on play on awake. That's why. Oh, it's not even loud. That's good. I tried to make it sound kind of digital because I like it when there's that kind of digital scary kind of sound, but it didn't come out quite right. But yeah, I made this little example for upcoming video I'm going to be making about events in Unity because they're literally the coolest. Well, if you're not using events yet and you're programming, you really should be. Because they just make so many things so much easier. You don't have to worry about so many things. Anyway, yeah, that's old Screechy Pete. So, hang on, I'm just gonna get some tunes on. Right, is that too loud or is that okay? Let me know. Let me know in the comments. I'm joking. I'm gonna do it one more time for good luck. Yeah. Oh, I just picked up the pen automatically, but we totally don't need the pen today. So, that's good. So we've got our screecher. Screecher's gonna screech. So hang on, I need to check the stream to just check that it's not too overpowering loud. Oh, it's not it's hardly loud at all. That's good. Oh fuck! Oh no! Sorry, double me. That's not good. I was watching the end of the fucking world. What's that? Is that a movie? Is it a movie where the things move? Do the moves? Anyway, so. I made this little screeching animation, or roar, maybe. It's called a screecher, so I guess it should, screech. That should be the name of the thing it does. But I don't know, I don't want to just. Screecher.screech sounds like swiper.swipe, from Dora the Explorer. So I don't know, man. Maybe I should just roll with that. Anyway, so yeah, this is the animation I came up with yesterday for the roar. I kind of made it quite jerky. I wanted it to have that kind of vibe of when someone's really angry or something and they're shaking as they do something. I wanted it to have that kind of vibe. And as we saw in like what happens in Unity, my idea with this enemy now is that when it screams, the camera will shake, and then that will kind of, while it's screeching, you won't be able to move. So it'll be kind of a really cool, like, add a layer to the gameplay, because it'll be like, maybe I'll place this creature in rooms with other creatures, so then you have to prioritize killing the creature, because if you don't kill the creature, then you're gonna get, like, every time it roars, you're gonna get frozen, and then an enemy can grab onto you or something. So as soon as you hear that and see that the screen starts shaking, you're like, fuck, there's a screecher, you know, I've got to deal with it somehow. So, yeah. That's that. It's weird, just from the name, Screecher, that someone suggested, that gave me an idea for the game mechanic. And, yeah. I'm not saying it's like original or anything, I'm sure games have probably done that, but I think it would be quite interesting in a survival horror game when typically enemies are more or less cut and dry, apart from maybe poisoning you or something like that. So we got the roar animation, we've also got this idle animation, which isn't really finished yet, it's more just, it's okay, it's like, it's just a standard kind of idle animation. Nothing to write home about. I'll probably go back and make it a bit more interesting. What I'm really interested in making will be like the... the baby's having a hard day. What I'm really interested in doing is... like a walking and a running animation. I'm not sure which is going to be harder, to be honest. I've never animated a creature of such shape before, so that'll be interesting. So I'm going to create a new action here, and I'm going to call this action, let's see, walk. So I know, dude. So, yeah, each of these actions, if you haven't used actions in Blender before, they kind of represent one animation on its own, and then they make up a collection of actions, and when you export as FBX into Unity, you can just select each action. It'll be kind of really easy to import animations that way, which is why I don't just send the Blender file to Unity. Because you can do that too, but then you've got a huge, long animation that you have to break into chunks manually. So it's not very, it's not really a good way to do it, in my opinion. Now, I'm probably going to have to look at how a similar creature walks like this and use reference from that in some way. I've got to think about what creature might be similar to this. Because it can't be... I mean, I was thinking it looks kind of insectoid. Hey. Hey, Micro. How's it going? Guys, if you're not already, subscribe to Micro Games. He's a really cool guy, and he's got very good videos, funny videos in a similar vein to mine. Check this out, Mike. I don't know if you were here when I played it. This is the creature screeching and making the character lose his shit. I'm really into it. Yeah, I'm gonna make a video about how to do the events to set that up, so I hope people find that interesting. Oops, not Cubase. I've got so many shit open, I was trying to get a bunch of that stuff done. Anyway. So I need to find a video of something that actually runs like that. So maybe a dog walking. Doesn't look anything like a dog. Can anyone think of... Thanks, Mike. Can anyone think of an animal that is kind of shaped this way? Maybe a gorilla from the way it's like walking, but I don't know if it should have the gorilla kind of swagger. Have you? But only focus on four legs. Maybe that's an idea. If I can bear to look at a spider crawling up close. So, Mike, have you animated like aardvark? Maybe from the face. Mike, I wanted to ask if you animate things with four legs, do you do IK on both the front and the back? Because that's what I've done like so far with this, and I don't know if it's like a normal way to do it, to be honest, but it seems like it might be limiting in some way. Like if I like try and bring his, oh, I can bring one arm up, but it's like his whole body kind of has to go with it. I don't know. It seems like it's the logical thing to do, but it makes like rotating the chest and stuff just a bit strange. Rah! Did he just like almost dab? Wait. Probably a tarantula. Yeah. Well, they all have a similar way of swaggling. It helps keep things easy. It looks like how you've written him looks like how he. Yeah. I get you. Yeah, I thought with the four-legged, it would just be like kind of weird to not to have the front legs not IK too. But anyway, walk. So I'm gonna just delete the rest of these things and think about which poses I need to think about for the spider. Oh. Yeah, like you're totally right. Oh, I can pop out this player. I forgot about that. So let's just pop out this player so we can watch together. If you've got arachnophobia, I'm sorry. I wonder if I could pin this on the top. Probably not. So it's like, yeah, it's similar to a spider, isn't it? So if I look at these, oh God, it's creeping me out a little bit. I'm not gonna lie. So that it's like one leg goes forward. Maybe if I make that pose of like one leg forward and one leg backwards, it will start to make more sense then. See, now he looks like he could be called a scuttler, innit, Kev? I should probably match the rotation of these things so it doesn't move around all the time. Yeah, it does diagonal patterns, right? I don't know. Actually, it seems like if that's the case, then the idle pose should be probably like this. The idle leg should be a bit forward, and then this leg should be more backwards. Maybe even further, because it feels weird stretching out like that long. So, I got the record button on here, and that means that I don't have to insert the keyframes manually. I don't use that all the time, but sometimes I feel like it helps me work a bit faster. Okay. Now, what else about how this spider moves? Well, it's hard to see any kind of movement in his body, let's say. So, I don't know. So, diagonal. Oh, this needs to come even further forward, I think. And I guess while those limbs are forward, the other one is backwards, right? See, this is the problem with the IK. But if I just mess with it, it should be all right. Oh, it's not so bad working like that, actually. Just need to think about what I'm doing. So, yeah, definitely priceless. I kind of like doing these animations where, like, if you look at my raw animation, the way I did this was by manually going like this. Like, you'll see what I mean when I play it. It gave it quite a natural feel, I think, and I left in some of the jerkiness because I just wanted that look. But I don't think I could make something that looks so kind of believable just doing it by hand, you know? So I'm quite happy, and I might use that kind of technique more and more to get the kind of thing I'm going for. See, this is a little problem. He seems like his body is shifting over a bit. Oh God. Yeah. Maybe this claw should just come kind of up. I'm not sure. So that one's, wait, that one's forward, so this one should be back. I just realized that I'm an idiot. I talk about your channel quite a lot, Mike. I've seen a few people ask me about how to do certain things, and it's like, oh, wait, I don't have a video on that, but I know this guy Mike, and he's got a good video on that. Wait, I'm losing my mind here. Am I doing it wrong? I keep thinking like, oh, I don't think I can blame my ADHD for this. So that's back, that's forward. That's back, that's forward. That makes sense, isn't it? Okay, so let's just, oh wait, what am I doing? I've got these all fucking mixed up. Let's put all of these together. Okay, I screwed up a bit. Why is it wobbling? That's weird. His head was just jerking, but it's like, that's weird. That's like a rotation thing. I think I'm gonna do it again. So this one goes forwards. This one goes backwards. This one goes, wait, what's the front leg? Forwards. This one goes, well, I think that is kind of backwards, but a bit more. Then I'm gonna do all eye available, just so that doesn't happen again. Straighten this up. Cool. Yeah, he's a pretty cool dog. Let's straighten this up a bit. I guess actually he should probably have some kind of rotation if that's what is. If that's what the IK is doing, it's probably because it's right. I can just rotate the head a little bit, make it more natural looking, if this thing could possibly look fucking natural. But just a tad bit more. So I can't help but feeling the back leg looks like it's way too far back though. So maybe I'll bring that in just a little bit. Maybe he doesn't need to go like that far back. Wait, what happened? I want the spikes to stick in the ground a little bit as well. I need to remember that to make it look like, well, because they're sharp, they're not going to just float on the top of whatever surface he's on. I want to give the impression that they're really kind of digging in as he walks. Maybe only a little bit though. So if I just, maybe like that. Maybe he needs a bit straighter back too. Yeah. let me just copy that over there. I think that given the design of creature is meant to look slightly unnatural. Yeah. Yeah, I guess you're right. Control shift V. Oh, something's gone wrong. Oh, you know what? Like, these IK bones aren't exactly symmetrical. I don't know why, but it's like I had to make a different one because I couldn't mirror the bones. So let me just try applying the rest pose quickly, if I can remember how to do that. Armature, wait, pose mode, pose, clear. Okay. Wait, no. Why is it like, that's weird. Oh no, I can't remember how I did that. Anyway, let me just try and do the thing with the stuff. Symmetrize. Oh, maybe that did work now. Oh, but... but if I move... Oh, hang on. Maybe it's just like copied that IK too. So, hang on. So, where's the IK for this? Oh, no. It's good. But it's the other claw. Needs to be there. But why is it forward? Oh. Like, it's weird, like, I was symmetrizing the bones so that it was both the same on the same side, and now, like, and I ended up having to make a new bone, which is why it's facing a different direction. I'm not sure, to be honest. Do you mean, like, the, what do you call it, the... the thing you usually put in front of the knee, because I didn't actually make one yet, if that's what you mean. But the main problem is that these bones are like not identical. I might actually delete half of it and symmetrize it again, see if that will work. See what I mean? Like, I selected all of these bones, including this one. And then I press to symmetrize, and it doesn't do anything about this bone. It's very strange. Is it, like, not parented to the armature? Like, doesn't make sense because I wouldn't be able to use it, right? Very, very interesting. Not 3D view, but... not properties. I forgot which one usually goes here. Oh, it is. Yeah. Wait, maybe if I go edit mode, let me clear the parent, and then... Okay. No, it's just fucking weird. Like, what's that all about? Like, it's definitely... I mean, it is part of it, you know? Let me name it so that it doesn't get messed up, because I've got some funny names going on anyway. Get to edit mode. Hang on. So that's front IK dot L. Like, it's the same as the, I'm gonna call this back so I just don't get confused. You know, it's part of the armature. Does it need to be parented to the pelvis? Like, I don't remember doing that, but maybe. No, because it, like, why would it do it for the front one but not the back? Like, oh, well, whatever I did, I've fixed it now. So I don't even know why. Anyway, let's see that if our animations have all screwed up now. It looks like it. Did I change the... Oh, man. Anyway, I can go and fix that later. That's not really that important. There's only two little animations. Anyway, this one might look kind of cool. Yeah, he's like ready. Maybe I can still use this. That's seeing the silver cloud in every lining. It's annoying when that happens in Blender. Sometimes, like, I fix something, but I actually just don't realize how it's fixed, you know? And it's like, well, it's fixed, but I haven't learned anything from this. Yeah, but I should probably use one of those, the pole targets, to be fair. Because it's going to get a bit confusing if I don't. So let's insert a new bone. Yeah, me too. I don't know. I'm just going to say it's Blender being fucking weird, as Blender is, as Blender does, you know. So I guess the pole targets should be up here. So let's insert a new bone if we're in, wait, where am I even? So add single bone. Which kind of bone types do you like working with, Mike? I prefer these skinny ones because the other ones look too chunky to me. I don't want to be offensive to the chunky bones, but these are just the ones I prefer. Okay, so where's this bone? So we'll call this pole target front dot L, and then just adjust it a little bit. Okay, that seems all right. Yeah, Jimmy. Always just use the big ones, no real reason except that it's... Oh, right. Prisoners movie. No. Is it good? Like, I want to use the big ones, to be fair, but they're, like, too big. Like... You know? They're just, like, chunking out the body, and I like to see the... shape properly. I don't know if there's a way of making them skinnier, but I haven't found a way. It's fucking great. What's it about? Is that a stupid question? We watched the second episode of Stranger Things last night. I'm getting pretty invested in it. It was just at the bit where the guy was taking pictures outside, like, the house where at the pool party or something. It's like, okay. Okay, dude. Okay, so that would be that one, that would be that one. I guess I can symmetrize them again. Anyway. Look at that. It's doing it again. I must be doing something funky. Is it like a naming thing? Oh, maybe it's because it's named Bone. That would be weird, isn't it? I bet it's because I named it Bone. Let me try this. Yeah, look, it works. Let me just double check that's why. I'm gonna call this Bone now. Symmetrize. Yeah! Fucking hell, like, naming things is always really random sometimes. That's a really dumb thing to say, isn't it? Always really random sometimes. Like, I find that in code, sometimes you name something like, and it, you know, just something friggin' don't work. Okay, so let's switch up. Oh, fuck's sake. Now this. Oh no, that's probably just, no, god damn it, pose. Wait, let's apply a rest pose. No. I should have done the rest pose first before doing that, I think. Oh god, and all of these bones in the middle are fucked up. I don't remember if there's a way to like completely clear everything. I could just like move these to zero. G. X zero. No. How would I do that? I forgot. Alright. G X zero. One. One. No? Oh wait, am I on the wrong axis? No? E, Y, 0. G, Z, 0. Life is strange. Don't know why I said that. Head, 0. Okay. Tail, 0. The fuck is happening? What's going on in this town? By the time I noticed something was wrong, the entire city was infested with zombies. Oh wait, I just needed to do one at a time. Tail, 0. 0. And I drop a trailer in Discord. Yeah, all right. What's the best season, like without spoiling things for me, what's the best season of Stranger Things? Let me just, I'm gonna have to re-kajigger all of these bones actually, but it'll be worth it, I guess. Season 2, yeah, and there's 3 seasons, right? Yeah. Well, I'm glad it's not like one of those that just goes on forever, because I get really sucked into things when I watch them, you know, like Breaking Bad. Like, I've watched that a couple of times, to be fair. I really, really enjoyed Breaking Bad, but it goes on and on. You have a, oh yeah, yeah, feel free to join the Discord. I'll just get a link for it. Copy, invite people. Yeah. So feel free to join. Kind of like to, I really like seeing things that other people are working on as well. I feel like since starting this, I've seen like so many people doing so much like cool stuff, and I'm like, I don't know, it really is like a cool to see other people who are still interested in these like old kind of graphics and stuff. It's so cool. I was thinking, like, if I was ever, like, really, like, had enough money to do it, it would be cool to open a studio that basically just makes games like Silent Hill and Resident Evil, like the old ones. Because there are other survival horrors you can play, but none of them really got me like those games did. Like Fatal Frame or anything like that. I never felt as invested or so into it, but like, I just love the old games. Haunted PS1 Discord. Ooh, no, I haven't heard of that. But I will check it out. If you can drop me a link, that would be awesome. So, yeah, I'm pretty much just gonna do all of this setup again. Make it perfect this time. Oh, I wanted to have these, yeah, like that. Yeah, I totally agree. I can, you know, it's like the Resident Evil 2 remake, for example. I can play it and I can enjoy it, but I can go back and play the original and it's like there's some quality to it that I just can't explain. Hey, Pyrewind. How are you? It's a really big Discord with a bunch of who make such retro style games developed from Sorcerer. Oh, wow, cool. To be honest, I haven't really played many other games that are kind of part of the kind of revival, you know? But I've seen some trailers from like those guys, or that guy, what's his name? The one who does all the 80s horror slasher stuff. I think we were talking about him the other day. Yeah, I'm doing well. I started on another medication today. I'm on like 4 now. It's pretty nutty. Puppet combo, yeah, that's cool. Okay. Yeah. So, just go to your... Apply rest pose. I'm on max, so playing just about anything is a pain, but puppet combo is on the list of things I need. Yeah. They did something, like, or he, sorry. I don't know if it, I think he gets other people to work with him, but, like, the atmosphere is really cool. Like, I think it's one thing that I don't have much experience in, is creating the kind of atmosphere and stuff. Now, I'm trying to think of a way to make this, like... Okay, well, maybe I'll be able to join at some point anyway. Anyway, well, this is alright. We don't need to worry about the rest pose just yet. Oh, is this, like, parented to wink things weirdly? No? So I guess I'll keep you updated. Okay. Yeah. I noticed when I added a little bit of a reverb into the rooms, it really added something. I try and think about sound quite a lot. Oh, hang on. How do I set it so the bones match in... edit mode. I know there's a way to do this. It's bugging me because it's like, I know I should be able to do that. Oh, is it clear transform? Did I just do it? Well, basically, yeah. Bones always going to be a bit fucking weird. I never quite understand what's going on, but yeah, it's all right. So everything looks like it's straight now and in time. If you get a link, DM. Yeah, that would be cool. I think half the like battle with game dev is just getting your stuff out there. I think you pretty much have to start a YouTube channel unless you've got some way of marketing the game, or unless you're already an established developer. Like, how else are people gonna even find out about your games? There's gotta be like hundreds of like really awesome games that never get seen. My hope is that if I just try really, really hard on it, then it will get out there. But to be fair, like, this is like a passion project for me, so the money is not something I'm really even thinking about. I have a job that I quite enjoy anyway. This is just what I do to express myself. But if I could, like, I don't know, make it, so to speak, that would be awesome too. Okay, so anyway, let's set this poll target. Where are they? Oh, sorry. Poll, okay, front. Poll target, front L. And then this one can be poll target, front R. Let's see that. Oh. Poll target, wait, armature, poll target, front, back, can't speak, and this one as well, poll target, back, right. Now, why isn't that working? I bet it's because of how things are connected. Let me just look at my other character quickly. I need to remember the full setup. Yeah, if you are into the stuff you see, a like would be appreciated, because then it might reach more people. Unless you have unless your finger and the wrist hurts slightly today, then I don't mind if you don't want to push it. Or if you're just lazy or anything, like, don't feel pressured. The last thing I want to do is to pressure you into pressing that thumbs up button. Anyway, yeah, this is my where was I gonna look? See, that was ADHD kicking in right there. So the poll target, right, do I need to do anything special here? Have you got a stream schedule? Yeah, you should create a thumbnail with a chick on it. Maybe I'll just put myself on it. Like, I think I might sell, just squeeze my chest together, you know. Stream schedule, I don't know really. Like, I've been streaming pretty much every day since I started streaming, but I don't know if it's going to carry on like that, because I mainly want to do content like God, I can't think straight. I mainly wanted to do content that was like God damn it. That's like, okay, so that's like fucking hell, my brain is going blank. Someone beat me up. Literally, ADHD is making me... Actually, it's the new medication, probably. I'm getting a bit forgetful, but yeah. So, I mainly want to do art stuff on stream. I don't really want to do stuff that isn't art stuff, because I have a hard time keeping my trail of consciousness, like, in a straight line anyway. So, coding takes a lot of my energy, if you know what I mean. So, but yeah. Hey, Saulo. I see the limbs are separated, but they are joined with the body, forming one. Yeah, so this is actually all part of the same mesh, but each thing isn't connected. So what I usually do is I create individual objects for the body part, then I join them all together. If you wanted to do something like dismemberment in your game, if you wanted to be able to blow the head off or blow the limbs off, then you could make these an object by, well, you just separate it, and then you could also have the bones work that way. The way that the bones kind of connect to this mesh is that each of these body parts is assigned to a vertex group. This has upper arm dot R, if you can see, dot L, sorry, here. So you assign all of the separate kind of connected pieces to a vertex group, and then it will just work with the armature. I kind of had trouble with that kind of stuff when I first started, and then I realized it was just way easier than I was making it. Saulo, how are you doing? And Herb, how are you doing? Have your energy levels been any better recently? Okay, so let's have a look at this. Maybe it's because like it's not connected. Maybe if I put IK, no, that's gonna be weird. Use tail. Oh. Yeah, I think I need to use the tail. Stretch, no. No, it should stretch, I think. Pole angle. This is weird. I haven't seen this kind of thing happen before. You made it twerk. Oh, you can change the chain length. Yeah, that's cool. One, two. Aha, okay. But so it should be three. But and then I need to change the angle, I guess. All right, and I'm gonna move this a bit further out so that it's easier to deal with. Now he's asking. Well, not really. I'm settling with a new dosage, a bit more. Nice. We'll see you in a week. Yep, and then the rotation. Aha. Salo, I'm confined to my girlfriend's house because my family members. Oh, I'm sorry about that. Does she at least have like, I don't know, like a, I don't know. Does she have an iPad that you can play Plants vs. Zombies on? Okay, so this is, yeah, this is, yeah. Oh, guys who are watching here, I'm kind of like, I'm making a video about how to create events soon, and this is the little this is a little preview of what you can kind of achieve with events, so check it out. I'm really I need to fix the sound a bit, but yeah, I love it. That's the first time I've ever made a screen shake as well, and it was literally the easiest thing. Well, I don't see how it could be hard, but okay, so we got the front. Probably want to just copy that onto the other side. So I'll just do the same thing again. Let's have a look at the. I wonder if I can copy this. I'm not sure if I've done that before. So it's three chain length and then 15, but maybe it'll be like minus 15, right? No. Okay. Oh, it would be -15 from 180, right? So, is it exactly -15.3? That looks good. I'm stuck all day on my phone. Need to see that vid. Yeah? That's nice. Are you more like on the programming side or the art side yourself, Mike? Route choices like in RE3, RE3. That would be cool. I'm not sure if it's gonna have a standard kind of linear story yet. I'm not sure how to do it yet, but that's something like that would be very interesting, yeah. So okay, yeah, I'm the opposite. Art is definitely the weakest. I only started using Blender maybe like a year or two ago. Okay, let's find the pole target here. So chain length again will be 3, I think. Oh God, what happened? No. Oh God. No, actually should it be 3? Like 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. What happened? Is there like a sneaky bone like I haven't even seen? Like what's happening? Back dot L. All right, that's pole target back dot L. What do you mean out of necessity, Mike? He twisted like yeah. 3. It's always something, isn't it? Can't just have a friendly neighborhood friggin' dude. Am I gonna have to like rejigger his whole posture or something? That's weird. Like, it's not even. They're both like unconnected. It looks like logically it should be the same, but it's just not. Thanks. I had not friends to cope. My wife had not introduced it, so I learned it. Yeah. So how long you've been coding then? Oh, maybe it's something to do with how like the knee is bent. Oh shit, it needs to probably be at the front, right? Maybe that's why. No. This is so lame. Is this parented like weirdly or something? Oh yeah, that's why. Oh my God, I'm an idiot. Wait. Everyone knew. Wait, no? Oh, dude, you're killing me. All right, so P, keep offset. All right. Now, don't you know go doing that stuff, okay? Yeah, so we're probably kind of opposite in that way. I've been programming a long time, but only really got into the 3D stuff very, very recently. Like, I would say I'm not like very, like, I can get things done eventually, but sometimes it takes a long time of searching and everything. This is a good example of my incompetence. Very strange. Well, how I got into programming was that my mom and dad like live separately, and well, they were like split up when I was pretty young, and I never on the weekends I could never go outside because I didn't know any friends. I didn't have any friends there. And sometimes my dad would take him to work when he had to work weekends. He worked as like the IT manager of some big firm in London, some lawyer place or something. So I used to get to play on the computers they had there. And for some reason they had Macromedia Flash. What one was it? I think it was 2000 and something. It was like a really, really early version of Flash, and that had ActionScript 2.0 on there. So I downloaded Flash at home, or my dad got me a copy, and I was just trying to make little Flash games online. And I still use Flash. I have it right here. I still use it for designing some thumbnails and stuff. But yeah, like all the weekends, I just used to spend learning to code and stuff, and doing shitty animations. But yeah, I was always like more on the programming side. Like back then, I used to just make circles move around and be the player, you know. And then, yeah, sadly, Flash died. But I guess it is kind of horrible. It's not the best thing now. Yeah. Well, yeah, it feels really good to be doing what I want to do finally, rather than sitting around, like, jerking around, you know? That's what it felt like. I was just, like, messing around with my life. I should have been doing something better, but I was just playing hooky on life. Yeah. You didn't have internet growing up. Whoa. Wait, Oh, you know what? Like, these are all kind of connected to the shoulder bone. This one, that's the IK, I guess, that it's showing, right? So, no, it's not. What's this? What does this relationship line mean? I'm confused. Maybe that's what's causing our issues. It looks like a parenting thing, but I'm not sure if it is. Interesting. That's the root. I wonder if that could have something to do with it. Because, like, the root of this one is this shoulder joint, right? Not sure the leg is connected to the one above it. I think it is. It's parented. If that's what you mean. Yeah, but it seems like it's affecting the spine, right? Привет. Hello. I can't. I don't know how to say it properly. I'm sorry. Okay. Yeah. Like unparenting it seems to have done something. That's so weird. I'm like an idiot, like, I swear. What happens if I parent it to... Wait, not connected. Hey, thanks, dude. I really appreciate that. Like, they can be connected just with an offset, though, right? Like this. Oh, now it's doing it. So what's the issue here? Yeah. Are you also making games? I don't know how to say your Russian name. If you can tell me like a nickname I can use or how it's pronounced, I can call you by that. Yeah, Blender's just weird for me, man. Doom. Oh, wait, that bone is facing the wrong way, maybe? No? Yeah. Yeah, maybe you're right. Hang on. You do that in this, right? Pose mode. Apply pose as rest pose. Oh yeah, okay. Oh, okay. I'll try and remember that. I'll write that down. God, are we actually gonna animate anything? It's nice to see you here, by the way. Hi, Wind. Yeah. I've missed you. You give me great honor for being here. Wait, what the hell has happened here? This has all gone crazy. I know about applying, like, or resetting things, like, transforms and stuff like that, but I didn't know anything about bones, to be fair. I'm so confused right now. I feel like I've lost a bone. But it's good to like get this stuff sorted before you start animating. Cause I had to fix like a, I had to scale an animation once and that was so fucking annoying. Oh, I see what's happened. Jesus. There's gotta be an easy way. Yeah, knowing how they bend and such. That's it. So I think these are supposed to be connected. No, I'm backing up here because there should be an easier way than this. Yeah. Okay, so we're back in this state now. You got no movement on there. So this is connected to this one. Propagate pose, what does that mean? LP, clear parent. Okay. Oh wait, what was the even problem? I forgot. It's not really hard to show you. I either know what kind of bone it's connected to. My only regret is I have bonitis. I like that episode, Futurama. Disconnect bone. Now let's try doing the rest pose. Pose mode. Wait. Now the arm is breaking, like, now everything's breaking. Maybe if I I'm gonna unparent it from the armature so we can really figure out what is the issue here. Okay, it's just rotated like that because I had it rotated for export to Unity. You never saw it? It's a pretty good one. Season 4, I think. Well, season 4 in the UK, season 5 in the US probably. We had different seasons of Futurama. Mike, this is a awesome to the max. This is a question for you. Is there any way of making the bones in edit mode and object mode the same? Because they always seem to like be off and I'm not sure like why. I think in animations mode, the positions are technically... Okay. Now it's just the arms, that's weird. So I did something. Need to select every bone, yeah. Yeah, I did Alt R, I did Alt G, Alt S, and that should be in edit mode, right? Maybe this is just because of the pole target things. Yeah, that's why, right? Yeah, I think I... Wait. So I just need to make these match now. Okay. Okay, yeah, it's definitely something with the pole target then. Maybe if I try resetting that now. Oh, okay. Thanks. So... Let me just set up that pole target again then. For some reason I can't redo what I did. Bugger. That sounds strange when someone from across the pond says it. Do you say that too? In the, you're in America, right? Oh damn, I removed all of the IK. I'm an idiot. That's annoying. Yeah. Definitely. So let's, I'll get this like this and then, no? Hmm. Weird. Like, I think feel like I should have the tail thing on. Yeah. Like, maybe it's not such a big deal, I don't know, but... Oh, they're not even parented anymore, so... Yeah. Maybe it's, this is one of those things that's not as big a deal as I'm making it. Can you, like, mirror the pose? Yeah. I'm sure you can copy one half of the pose and paste it on the other side. Yeah, it's this pole talk, it's making it weird. But it should be able to rotate, like, I don't know, it feels like it's... Like, I need to bring the bone down. Like, refuses to rotate down. That's the issue. I don't know why. All right. Yeah, yeah. So, if I just... move this. Oh, okay, maybe that will help. Oh, these things are able to kind of split out as well. That's a bit weird. Yeah. Yeah. Wait, FK? What do you mean by FK? Oh, okay. So that's like the standard operating procedure then, I guess. Yeah. Yeah, I get it. I kind of just figured out what IK really means. Thanks. Okay, so... Right, let's try resetting all of this stuff. Right. God damn it. Thank you. Why is it doing that now? Blender, why? Some things I just don't understand, and I never will. Well, maybe I will. Yeah, I know, but I just want to fix it, you know. I hate it when there's something that I'm not sure how it's working, because I know that it can end up being an issue later on. That was kind of... That's kind of how I... Well, I learned that the hard way with programming, you know. It's like sometimes you can... In the past, I did a lot of copy and pasting, you know, and just thinking, oh yeah, like I found it, it works, so that's good enough. And then there's times when, like, you basically fuck yourself up because you look back at some algorithm and something and you're like, how does this work again? Oh, I don't understand. So I always, like, until I understand my system, I won't usually stop. But it's kind of a, at some point, I think it does become like, you don't need to be doing it, you know? And it's a bit like, unnecessary. But it's just paranoia that comes with that I just have, I guess. Clear all. I just want to clear everything. Yeah, I haven't really done much animation, to be fair, so I'm sorry for people watching who was expecting to see some animation. Yeah. So, what is it that's causing this weird thing now? I'm sorry to keep asking questions, but this. I think you already explained to me once, but my brain has just gone. Maybe I need to do the rest pose again, no? Oh, I just cleared the transform and that did it. Okay. Okay, now I feel like I can go ahead and make the do the things I wanted to do in the beginning. So this is connected to that. So I'm gonna add the IK at the back first. See if I can get it done. Yeah. Okay, so I feel like things are gonna go better this time now. Armature, back, IK, L, and then. Oh, actually, before we do that, I'm gonna parent it to the body again. So, I mean, I'm gonna parent the body to the armature. Empty groups. Okay. Everything should be in order now. Yes. Okay. Oh, actually, that shouldn't be that shouldn't be bending. That shouldn't be stretching with that. It should be separate. That's very not good. Everything else is. Hang on, I better sort that out. Welcome to my life, how I constantly operate. So I need to separate these things. Split them, I should say. Split. That should be better. I want these to be separate because they will be retractable. No. Okay, those ones are okay. But it must mean that the vertex groups in these are doing too much. So let's have a look at that. Vertex weights, no. How about in this? Vertex weights, hand. Vertex weights, foot. Vertex weights. Oh, maybe it was just because of the, because they weren't split up. I don't know. No. It's very strange. Doing something weird. L, drag it away. Maybe it's just like these. Are these on the... Yeah, they are. They're on the foot. Motherfucker. Get off there. Lower leg dot L should be there. Wait, I should probably just hide that and not move it. L, shift H. Select these. And then... Wait. Lower leg dot L. Assign. And then we'll do the same for both sides. Alt H to unhide. L, shift H, and then select these. How old are you, by the way, Mike? Like, roughly. I want to see if you're like a similar age to me. You sound kind of younger than me, though. I'm not sure. Yeah, I'm 29. You're older than me then. Okay. Young bastards, yeah. Kev's just slightly older than that. Okay, lower arm dot R. Okay, so probably missed something because I always do, but oops, what the hell am I doing? Pose mode. See, yeah, so that the front of them is still slightly connected. It must be the top of the spikes now that are also so let's shift H. Ugh. What happened there? So, what are you? What's your weights? hand, lower arm. Aha!
I found you.
Yeah, I've seen a few of Mike's videos before we actually met too. So that's okay, but there's still issues. Yeah, you should, Franks, you should definitely sub to this fella if you're not already. He's got a ton of cool stuff. Alright, one side's working. Good. Oh, thanks, dude. One thing I like to do is I usually make the thing with really bad geometry, and then later I just, you know, get in as much as I need for the detail, and then I like to just go around and removing shitloads of edges. This isn't the only version I did. I also did a more like wait, is this the one? No, that's not the one. I'll show it a different time anyway. But yeah, the texture isn't quite finished. Like, some of it's just sloppily put together, but yeah. Glad you like it. All right, let's get rid of some of this stuff. Now let's do the same for the back. I was saying on stream yesterday, after I've done like a survival horror game, the next thing I would want to do would be a game based on Metal Gear Solid in the old style. So that's all foot stuff. foot stuff is good, obviously. So this is foot and leg. Snake. Like, I love Metal Gear Solid with all my heart, and I really think that the first one is probably my favorite too. I love Metal Gear Solid 2, don't get me wrong, but I just love Metal Gear Solid 1 so much. I also love Metal Gear Solid 2 so much, but for different reasons, I guess. I like how Metal Gear Solid 2, they really leaned into the more, like, absurd kind of stuff with, well, I don't want to spoil it for anyone, but yeah. But Metal Gear Solid 1 is just so, like, ugh. I could play that any day. Like, I could just play it through. And whenever I do play it, I just play it all the way through. Okay, we should be gravy now. Out of shame, I have yet to play it. Wow. Yeah, I reckon it's still really playable. When did you play the MGS song? Well, I've been playing it for like 10 minutes, I guess. Yeah, there we go. All things disconnected. So this way they can retract back in at some point. Let's do the poll target stuff and all of the stuff. Everything's nicely aligned. No issues there. I can't see any problems. It's the soundtrack for Metal Gear Solid 1 I'm playing. Yeah, I won't say anything else about Metal Gear Solid 1 then, but yeah, man, like... Whew. But yeah, that's one of my life goals. It will be make a game like Resident Evil, make a game like Metal Gear Solid, then make a game like old point-and-click adventure games. That one probably won't take too long. And then make a game like the old Final Fantasy games, like Final Fantasy 7, 8, 9. But by that point, I hope I have a studio, because I won't be able to do that on my own, I think. That's not true. Okay, so inverse kinematics, bone, front IK dot L, poll target, I'll do the poll targets last actually, maybe it is, maybe it isn't, front IK dot R. Okay. Wait, what? What's going on in this town? Okay. Okay. Inverse kinematics. Wait, let me check that's working. Doosh, oof, oof, oof. Push-ups, baby. IK, amateur, back IK.L. No, something's fucked up there. Why is this bone brown? Oh, okay. Sorry. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, what the fuck? It's doing it again? Oh, no. That's my own fault. Like, ignore me. He's getting pumped. Yeah, he needs to. Okay. What the frick? Am I like... Is there something wrong with me? Wait. Oh, wait. Back IK dot... Oh, okay. I'm an idiot. He's feeling the pump. Watching the burn. Feeling the pump. Watching the burn come and get. Now he's just, you know, just doing a funny little dance. I don't know. Definitely nothing more to it than that. Okay. Chain length 0, chain length 3. He is ready. Oops. Well, let's see if we can do the pole target this time without completely blowing everything up. Minus 63. So, armature, pole target. Wait, I need to do some quick maths. 180 minus 63, 117. Now, was it exactly that? 63.2, okay. Okay, please don't do something dumb this time. I feel like this was way harder than it needed to be. I think I just made some really dumb mistake early and didn't realize. Like, I'm almost certain actually that's what happened, because look at this, like... Oh my god. I think it was just literally the chain length that I was screwing up. Yeah. Makes me feel like a really smart kind of guy. Hey, Paul Caveworks, welcome, dude. It's nice to see you. Hope you're doing well. Are you a game dev too? Alright, 92. Oh, wait. 92 on this side, I think. 92.9. Okay. I would like to move these pole targets a bit further away as well. I usually end up doing that. Uh,
just because it makes the most sense to me.
Wow, we got 17 likes today. That's awesome. I feel like some kind of pretty okay guy. Getting all the likes. Thanks for the likes, everyone. Have you considered doing a stream, Mike? Showing part of your process. Okay, so let's animate. Yeah! Wow, this like song just came out at the perfect time. I don't know if you guys can even hear it. But yeah. Yeah. I don't call it evasion. I call it avoision. Did anyone get that reference? Nerves? To be fair, like, before I went on my anxiety medication, I probably would have been the same. Like, to be fair, like, yeah. Who's there? Wait, what do you mean? Is someone here? Like, yeah, before I was put on my anxiety medication, I would have been, like, really freaked out about live streaming again. I did live stream for a while before, but yeah. Hey, ordinary player. These game dev streams are fun. As a composer, music streams, I'd say, seem a bit boring. I don't know. It depends, like what you do with it, I guess.
Only a fool trusts his life to a weapon.
I'm sure you can have make plenty of fun on a music stream too. Like, you could, I did that before, to be fair. I was doing some music stream, just playing guitar and making songs about the people that came into the chat. But that took my energy so fast. And also, like, it you have to be someone who wants to watch cringy things to enjoy that, because I'm just so cringe in that kind of situation.
Say to your wife that a fan said hi. Okay.
Sitter tube? What the fuck is a sitter tube?
You know what the thing that is kind of annoying about this way of working is that I can't seem to find a way to get the knee in the air without it. It's because this leg is kind of naturally bent. So I guess you do the bending there. Okay. I want them to be kind of parallel to the back ones. Yeah. Music jams. Definitely. What kind of music do you play, dude? Do you play on the spoons? I mean, I like spoons. Okay. Vibe a lot of genres. So you just be vibing all sorts of things. That's what you're saying. That's nice. I like someone with vibe. Oh, cool. So, can you show the animations? Yeah. Check this out. Are you ready for this? Mr. Ordinary Failure, this is gonna blow your little socks off. Wait. I like metal too. I like progressive metal a lot. That's probably, or just progressive music in general. He mad, yeah. Like I was telling people earlier, I was gonna create like a mechanic where the screecher screeches and you're kind of frozen in place while he does it. So other enemies will be able to come at you while he's screeching. And so it'll be like a priority thing. Your priority will usually be to kill this guy first. Yeah, I really love, if you like progressive and metal, listen to a band called Haken. Like, they're seriously cool. Maybe I'll put it on here now and just get a, I don't know if I'm allowed to, but they're just a really cool band. I hate everything about you is a cool song. I don't know. Isn't that Puddle of Mud that made that song?
Hate everything about you.
No, I mean to play it over the thing. But yeah, this is the... it called Haken. Is it not Puddle of Mud? Oh. Puddle of Mud. Oh, I was thinking of She Hates Me. And that, no, there's an Ugly Kid Joe song called Everything About You, and there's a Puddle of Mud song called She Hates Me. But the Everything About You says that I hate everything about you. Not allowed. I guess I won't then. I'm gonna keep playing just, I'm gonna keep playing video game music then, so I don't get, like, attacked. So, guys, what's your favorite Final Fantasy game? What 3D engine is this? This is Unity, Christian. I personally love Unity. I would say that once you pick up Unity, yeah, that's my favorite too, Mike. High five. I just looked like there was a webcam here, but there wasn't. But yeah, high five. Me too. Anyway, ADHD suddenly took over again. So, let's create another pose that's like here. FPS Maker. Yes! Okay. Oh my god, that looks so silly. Obviously, we need some more key poses here. He looks like he's just scattering along the floor. Final Fantasy.
I friggin' love Final Fantasy VII, dude. Yeah, it was released last time. They were working on, like, Final Fantasy X at the same time as 9, I think. Blood Skater. Yeah. He looks like he's going backwards. Wait, if I play it backwards, he'll probably go, like, forwards then. How do I play it backwards again? I forgot. No, he still looks like he's going backwards. Oh, was I playing it? I don't like Final Fantasy. I don't blame you if you've only been exposed to the more, like, recent ones. Hey, Alex. How you doing? Yeah, and 9 was left in the dust. Yeah, we do know. Like, I play it every single year through again. It's just, like, I relate so much to some of the characters in that game. Like, I thought 8 was good, too. But, like, for me, it didn't have enough, like, about the characters. Like, it seems really empty in a lot of ways for me. Good to hear that. Oh, I know what's weird. He's taking his, like, right foot forward first. No, it should... Wait. Maybe if I try it the other way, it'll look a bit more natural. So he starts off here. And then... But maybe we can lift the leg in the air, like he just don't care. It feels weird not to be able to rotate the arm, though. That's the only thing that bugs me about the IK, the way it is on the front there. That's good to hear. What have you been up to? Let's have a look from the top view. I think the front, maybe the claw should come out a bit further, like he's really prancing. I think there's a way to make the... If you're talking about some giant dong, then it's not happening. We tried it once, it didn't work. Oh, I guess he just needs to, like, come out this way a bit to get that effect. Ah, I see what's going on now. No. No ding dong tactics. If you make him walk asymmetrical, he comes off more horrors. Asymmetrical? Oh, you mean like walking wonky? So like not perfectly symmetrical walking? Yeah, we can do that. I might make it just tuck in a little bit inwards for this part. So he's like extending it out there. Any four-legged animal. Have you seen many four-legged animals that look like this? High wind, sorry. Because I want to live where you live, if that's the case. I want to go to Swindon.
but he walk out of sync.
Well, maybe I could just kind of shift his body, not out of sync, because the laws of physics dictate that he should walk in a way that lets him walk, right? But I was thinking more that he could, like, do this kind of thing while walking, and it will, like, you know? Yeah. I don't know what I said, so I don't know how to say it again. Yes, the sway is the way. I agree. So, I'll probably just do the arms first. Arms and legs, I should say. Oh, I guess, like, wait a minute. This is the opposite way around that it should be. I'm so fucking confused. I'm so, like, special in some ways of operating. I don't know how to explain it, but my brain is just so stupid sometimes. Oh, camel spiders. Jesus. Yeah, my cousin was in the army, right? And he said that they used to... Wait, no, I'm doing it wrong, aren't I? Oh my god, I'm an idiot. Because if I just mirror this, it's going to look fucking weird now. Like he's skating. Wait. So copy, wait, I need to probably, yeah, I'm being stupid again. All right, Mike, I think diagonally opposite legs should be moving together, but offset by, okay. Yeah, Australia Wildlife really is a horror movie. So I'm just going to lift this leg up a bit while he steps back. Oh, they can't step at the same time. That wouldn't be logical, as Spock would say, I guess. So if I put this leg, like, already contacting now... So he's like... but it shouldn't move after the contact point, I guess. An enemy covered in mold would be cool. Yeah, it would be. We were thinking about, like, doing some potato mold. Like, because of obviously the creature is designed after potatoes. So that would be cool. Hey, Amelius, how you doing? Nice to see you again. Mold man. Yeah, that's like the mold from Resident Evil 7, isn't it? Those things are fucking horrible in VR. Separate animation for each leg. I think it would be kind of overkill for this kind of project. Probably, but it might take like a long time to get that kind of system working, you know? Like, you can do that sort of thing procedurally, I know, but yeah, it's not something that I'm probably gonna think about. Like, I think, do you mean for like when he turns and stuff, it'll be like particularly realistic or something? Or for what purpose? Then you offset the phase. I think, to be fair, like, it'll be able to do it this way. It will just take a bit of time to get it to look right. And especially once, like, start animating, like, the torso as well, just adding a few things there will help it look more realistic. Because obviously when he pushes up here, his whole body should push up. So we can, you know, do stuff like that. That will help get things a bit realer. I'm looking for a PS2 on eBay while I'm what? Nice. I still have my PS2. Well, I have a PS2, not. I got one for speedrunning because it was like supposed to be like a faster or better loading times for certain games, I think. I just need to think about how this motion really looks, because I'm having a hard time visualizing it right now. Maybe I need to look at the spider video again, but I don't want to freak people out too much. Only a little bit, you know. I have Japanese white PS2 and black. Nice. So at this point, I guess one of his back legs should probably be straight, right? And probably the same one as the opposing. That might help things a bit. Maybe if we raise the pelvis up at the back a bit, while that happens. Oh, but it should start off bent. It's starting to look a bit more cromulent. Hello. All right. Is the baby here? Okay. All right, guys. I gotta end the stream so we can put the baby to bed. I'll keep on doing this on the next stream, which maybe will be tomorrow. Get in there. So if you aren't already subscribed and you're interested in this game dev PS1 horror stuff, then yeah, give me a sub, and I'm uploading a video tomorrow all about C# events and how cool way of using them is, and in a really basic way, so anyone who doesn't use events yet can learn how to make something like this happen. So everyone have a nice time. Oh, sorry, one thing that is just a suggestion: if you go ahead and move the entire body forward, it will help you physically visualize what you were doing. Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. I haven't ever thought of that before. Yeah. Thanks, Mike. All right, see you later, guys. Take care. Enjoy your whatever day it is. Enjoy your Thursday. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. All right, dead volume. See ya.